Another verse there says, if gold has become my God, you can come to the place, child of God, in the blessing of God, where either God is your gold or gold is your God. Write it down. Either God is your gold. No, I'll get you the scripture. There's not something I can skip. Let's go to Job. I bet you it's there. Job chapter 31, verse 24. Give me quickly. I have a lot of things to sort out. If I have made gold my hope. Another translation says, if I have made gold my God. If gold is your God or God is your gold. Child of God, no matter how God blesses you, God is your gold. Give the Lord a hand. Oh, clap well. I'm not excited about that. So David fulfilled, number one, he did not multiply horses. He fulfilled number one, but he did not fulfill number two. He accumulated wives and they turned his heart. David had a giant, which was the spirit of lust. Child of God, you've got to know what your weakness is. Every striker looks at the area of the weakness of the goalkeeper. Now, we are going to look at how did David, a man after God's heart, we said grace, come to the place where he defaulted in his walk with God. How did the giant of lust overpower a man after God's heart? There were several combined factors. 2 Samuel, let's go back to chapter 11. This is a very deep study. Now, this is where I'm going to stay for a while. 2 Samuel chapter 11. How did the giant of lust overpower a man after God's heart? 2 Samuel chapter 11, 1 to 8. I'll be coming to the peak of it. There were several combined factors that in a homecoming, as a child of God, in the midst of all the fun, the euphoria, the excitement, you've got to look at. Number one, the first thing that brought David down, the giant, was neglect of duty. When kings go to war, anyone in the church, when you begin to miss church, as you used to do, is the beginning of your trouble. When kings go to war, you are a sectional leader, you are a choir leader, you are a line leader, you are an evangelism leader, whatever leader, you are a serious member of the church, and suddenly you begin to slow down, the enemy has set his eyes upon you. At a time when kings go to war, David stayed at home. If David had gone to church, had gone to the battlefield, he wouldn't be in this problem. Bible scholars say at this time, David was about 50 years, in his mid-50s. The first problem was neglect of duty. Mid-50s. He wasn't young, he wasn't old. So he wanted to find out whether his performance rate. At a time when kings go to war, you begin to miss midweek service, you will not join the prayer team, now you don't go for outreach, you miss all the things, and now you move to social clubs, secret societies, you have fun more than the word of God. It is the time when kings go to war. Neglect of duty was the first problem David faced. That in a program like this, in homecoming, is an awakening. We are here to pat each other on the back, but it's also a time for self-examination. Because you can be in Bethel and not be in El Bethel. You can be in the house of God and not know the God of the house of God. Number two, ideal time. The second problem David that brought David down was he had a lot of idle time in bed. Instead of being at the war front, too much TV, soap opera, Nigerian movies, you are on WhatsApp the whole day. More WhatsApp than scriptures. There was a time when I went on WhatsApp. In about a week, I went off. But it was necessary by virtue of my work. But I have to discipline myself. Because every time, pop up, somebody has sent something. And a lot of crazy stuff. frivolities, and people want to download all their idleness upon you. And they take a picture, somebody is bathing, somebody jumped through a window. And when you are praying, you are checking your WhatsApp. When you are driving, and it can occupy your time. Child of God, our society is a more difficult time than the days of David. Today, the things that are calling for attention are more than David faced. So we are here for a wake-up call that in my homecoming, I'm going to take a decision that I'm going to be disciplined for God. Give the Lord a hand. Oh, do it well. Bonsam. Do it well. I am going to go back to Bible study. Homecoming. I am going to go back to the disciplines. I am going to go back to quiet time. Otherwise, it's only a matter of time. You see a Bathsheba you cannot handle. So the first thing that took David down was neglect of duty. Number two, idle time. Number three, success. Now, let me address this well. Success changes a man drastically. It affects the way you speak. Success can make you begin to speak carelessly. You tell your driver, oh, somebody blocks you. Oh, someone met you. Oh, yeah, you've not heard rich people. They do crazy things. So they just push his car away. Just push it, I can pay. Because he has a lot of money, he doesn't know what to do with it. Oh, bonusum ya koko tamenya lawyer papa. Oh, you are behaving as if you fell from outer space. These are things that happen here. Success can make you change. In fact, there is a word they call affluenza. From the word influenza. Influenza is medical for a sort of flu, a fever. And then rich people suffer from the form of it called affluenza. So, they buy things they don't need. You find a new bicycle lying in the corner. Something that somebody will save a whole year. They don't like it. Go to a rich man's home. There are a lot of things lying around that you see in your heart. You have been saving all your life to buy it. They don't like it. They don't like it. There was a guy in Nigeria we visited once. His cars were in air-conditioned garages. Maybe if you 3 days now, me na. Me da me teacher ma bo me yare. Because me na me ni air condition wami them. Gold-plated cars in air condition. He's gone to heaven now. He didn't go because of his cars. But I'm sure his time came and he went. At some point, everybody will go anyway. The things rich do. So you must position your mind now that when God blesses me, how am I going to respond? How am I going to live my life? That if David can go down like this, then it can affect anybody. That when I come to homecoming, I'm not just coming for frivolities. No. And for frolic, I am here for a self-appraisal. I'm here to re-examine my life. That if I'll possess anything, I'll possess the righteousness of God. Give the Lord a hand. So the Corinthians said, examine yourself and see whether you are in the faith. Wealth can change you. Can change you. But let me look at some serious, because there's a serious matter I want to address. Go into the word. Let's look at it. So we see success, reckless driving, you become loud, arrogant. You see, success gives you a false sense of, it gives you an invincibility. If it's a BBN to me, Money gives you a false hope. Even as a child of God. When you look at your account, the amount of money you have, and the things you can do, you can break heads. You can make and unmake. And you look at yourself. But you see, all your life is the breath in your nostrils. That's all your life. all your life. All your life. Wushishinuhuhu is the breath in your nostrils. If God takes it right now, you are dead. As long as you remember that, you will humble yourself. Because success can give you a false sense of invincibility. You can become arrogant. He said, pride. David knew that God was with him. And the fifth thing was neglect of the spiritual man. You can come to the place where you are so blessed. You don't come to fasting and prayer meetings. He said, when you give, when you pray, when you fast, neglect of the gift of God. And so, Paul wrote to Timothy, tell those who are rich in this present world, catch it on. They should not trust in uncertain riches. 1 Timothy 6:17. Tell them, we are so focused to catch it on. They should not trust in uncertain riches. Money has wings. I've seen rich people standing by the roadside. Never bluff your pastor with your money. Never. I don't know why this warning. Never. Anything God gives you, hold it with an open palm. Give the Lord a hand. So 2 Samuel chapter 11, the Bible says, from the rooftop, David saw. The first key to your escape, be careful what you see. He saw. Beautiful woman. Look at it. He saw. He wanted. He took. The mind is the battlefield. Don't let your erection determine your direction. You will never forget that. You will never. You forget it to your own head. And I'm not afraid to repeat it. You are not the one who paid me. It is God. Don't let your erection determine your direction. I'm telling you. The challenges for a believer today are more than those of David. Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp. Don't let your erection determine your direction. Our generation, there are things you see and your heart, whether you're a man of God or not. Your heart will be beating. And the Bible says, and Joseph fled. He didn't stand there arguing with Potiphar's wife. And you maybe any argument too. Give the Lord a hand. This is not an economics lecture. And Joseph fled. He left his Christmas dress in the woman's hand. At least the dress cannot commit sin. It's the body. It takes two to tango. If the body is not there, there will be no sin. You don't commit sin in absentia. He was not there. Give the Lord a hand. I'm going to show you something mysterious. Look at it. Look at it. Very beautiful. We are coming to a major part. David had been king for 20 years. A man of God. Mighty warrior. Ah! Look at it. You see, but Satan hides all the facts until it is too late. So sleep with that. Nothing will happen. So no. You live in fear. Sin causes fear. Bondage. Possibility of scandal. 2 Samuel 11:27. No. Okay, we'll get there. Now, let me show you something. Give me a wave. I'm going to move you into academia briefly and show you something. The Bible says, David sent and called her and took her. David is king. He has the right to do it. That doesn't make it right. There are two major philosophers in history who have shaped thoughts. One was the Italian Renaissance scholar called Machiavelli. He said the end justifies the means. And some Christians apply that. No matter how I get it, I steal, I rob, I sleep with the boss, as long as I get it, it's okay. And that's where David got it wrong. That the end justifies, you heard it before. It's from Machiavelli. He said, the end justifies the means. But God said, no. The means and the end are one. Tonight, I'm educating you, Major. Machiavelli says, the end justifies the means. How I get it, that's a political thought. How I get it doesn't matter, as long as I get it. If I sleep with my boss and I get promotion, no problem. Promotion, I may pay. Also, I'm better than one promotion. I bear meaning. Promotion, fair promotion. The end justifies the means. If I steal and I get it, I've gotten it. Right? Stealing doesn't make the difference. But there's another scholar called Immanuel Kant. He said, no. The end is pre-existent in the means. He said, the end of what you do is hiding in the means. And I'm going to read you a strange scripture. Give me the last verse of that chapter. 2 Samuel chapter 11. This one I'm going to shake you up. Look at it. Give it. Boy, I mean, 2 Samuel chapter 11. Where are you? Oh. 2 Samuel, it's not. The guy is gone home. Huh. Look, this scripture will change your life forever. And when her mourning was over, David sent and brought her to his house. This is the king. Why in the bet me akache nsaadi awe nenye? He has power. This is what wealth, riches, and power can do to you. What he's doing is not good. But nobody can say, David, hey, stop it. You have taken the man's wife, you have killed him, and now you have brought her to your house. He sent and brought and became his wife. But the thing, God didn't even mention adultery by name. It is so serious, God didn't mention it by name. Thing. Nee. Adiana David, yeah, no. Adiano. Look at somebody and ask, what is your thing? I can put down the mic and run away. My job is done. Obia wanadie. Your thing. Today we will find out. The thing that David did. But the thing that David has done, he didn't displease the government. He didn't displease his council of chiefs. He didn't displease his son Absalom. He displeased the Lord. Displeasing the Lord is the most important thing in life. The thing. And now my title for my message is The Thing. Give the Lord a hand, amen. Tonight the question is, what is your thing? We are here for homecoming. We can laugh, frolics, frivolities, jump, pat each everybody on the back and roll things under the carpet and it can be business as usual. No, but we want to come clean because the future is great. Success is going to come. Blessing is going to come. Honor is going to come. But what is your thing? The thing that David did. What is your thing? And I can give you a sample of some today. Pornography can be your thing. Porno. If we take your iPad right now, there'll be chaos here. That is your thing. The thing that David did displeased the Lord. Today, anything that displeased God, you are going to come clean. Give the Lord a hand. The thing. Let's talk about the thing. There is something we should talk about. The thing. God will not even mention. Onyami akume tuyabu ambodin. Onpese be free nenum. Obi to make an onu nyami di on to me. God wasn't going to mention it by name. It was a sacrilege. He said the thing that David had done. God didn't even say adultery or fornication. He said the thing. For some of you, your thing. Your boyfriend in the office is your thing. 12 o'clock, you remove your wedding ring. Your thing. Some of you smoke. Yeah, I've been pastor many years. Don't dare me. The things I know, you have no idea. If we preach like this, it's because of things we know. I went to preach in Accra here. Powerful, big church. And God told me, the head usher is a homosexual. It was so serious. When I started ministry, I told the pastor, I'm going to give an altar call. Please, I'm not embarrassing you. But God told me yesterday, your head usher is a homo. He's a gay. He said, hi, Bishop, you are going to spoil my church. I said, let's put it to test. It's either me or you is lying, but I heard from God. When I gave the word, I said, you are here. You are head of a department, and you are homosexual. The guy was carrying the offering basket. He dropped it and turned around. The pastor went and blocked him. So the thing Bishop James, Pastor James said, did you hear? He said, yes. He said, are you? He said, I am. Since I was before I came to church, but I've not changed. And I still am. The pastor went and sat down quietly. Because where the brother is. The thing, he was in the church. There are believers who smoke. The thing, there are believers on drugs. Was she clean? Oh, give the Lord a big hand. Hey. Do it. Clap unto the Lord. The thing, masturbation. Bishop. Minire. Ejaweana. Minisha me how far. Bishop, but like my wife, one who got Romo, and no one in Kekwani B. It's called self abuse. So you stay 3 hours in the bathroom, warming yourself up. Wait till you marry when you cannot perform. Masturbation. There are some believers who say it's all right, it's not. Because you cannot have masturbation without putting your mind on a woman. Incest. I've dealt with cases. Incest. That thing. Incest. That thing. Armed robbery. Go to East Legon tonight and see. Girls standing by the roadside. And I hear some of them are born again. Around a bit, please, they're on the line. It's area road to road. See the young girl, 16, 17, skimpy, wicked knickers. Wicked skirt. The skirt, wicked. Wicked. Skirt, look around, who are you coming back to? Everything on public display. And some believers can metamorphose in the night. Stealing tithes. The thing. A big charismatic church in town, a Pentecostal church, they caught a deacon with offering in his, counting money in his socks. Chrome 4. The thing. Premarital sex. The thing. One day a sister was passing by me and the condom fell out of her bag. Yankan yourself. I ask her, are you a pharmacist? Give the Lord an amen. At the back of the church, it was a titanic battle. The thing fell out of her bag. She was standing there. I stood akimbo. Is it your pastor who should take it? She stood and said, Kotonafa. He said, Pastor, I cannot bend down. I said, lie down and take it. Give the Lord a hand, amen. The thing, the thing. You know your thing. The thing. Premarital sex. Bishop, my father said, I cannot buy a car I've not taken to road. I must try the car, whether it will work. My father said he doesn't know whether the engine is good. So the church member is the car you must try. So Sunday morning, she comes from the boyfriend's house to church. Well, better not so them are famous. Oh, sorry. Pastor, can be an way free. Now, carry your sister in the bag. The tin. The tin. Homecoming. This is homecoming. Give the Lord a hand, amen. That thing David did displeased the Lord. Sometimes everybody can be pleased. We are talking about what God thinks. It displeased the Lord. Nobody could say David had you can do everything. Everybody can say you are right. Let's ask what God thinks. It displeased the Lord. Friday, you are in the boy's house till Sunday. He hasn't married you. He sleeps with you free. High purchase or cash and carry. It's high purchase or high cash and carry. Cash and carry. Marry me at once. High purchase. We haven't paid, but we are using it. If you don't laugh, they'll think you are the one I'm talking about. Give the Lord a hand, amen. The thing David had done. You buy things, you don't pay. So you change places in church. You owe everybody. It's your custom. You did it in action. You have come here. From here, you go to assemblies. The thing. Everybody has a thing. Mind your own business tonight. The thing David had done displeased the Lord. Tonight, you should ask yourself, my problem may not be this one, but it is this one. David wrote two Psalms, Psalm 32 and Psalm 51. He said, Lord, take not your Holy Spirit from me. David is in heaven. Thank God, God is a forgiving God. Tonight. Keep on clapping. Keep on clapping. Keep on clapping. Makada bobo shata. Keep on clapping. Zandala baba taka sataka. Ragada baka taka shaya. Whether it's chat room, whether it's fornication, lying, adultery, cheating, pornography, smoking, multiple girlfriends, armed robbery, stealing, tithes, falsifying accounts in the office, committing abortion, premarital sex, swapping. Saturday, you bring your wife, I bring my wife. You take your wife, I take my wife. Come on, son. Che, if you say a woman has his own, this world is changing. You cannot be an ignorant pastor. You've got to know things around you. I'm telling you. You bring your wife. I bring my wife. You take my wife away, I take your wife. Then one day you bring her back. But suppose you perform better than me. What do I do? If you outperform me, you take her home and do better than I do. And let me end there. At least she's used to what she knows. Good or bad. This world is changing. Can you imagine that you take your wife and give to somebody for one weekend and then you take somebody's wife? It's a crazy world. And there are a lot of things that have come into the church. The thing that David did displeased the Lord. I close. We can call sin a mistake. We can call it an accident. We can call sin a one-night stand. We can call it a work of the flesh. Oh, a chemical reaction. We can call it a moral weakness. Oh, no, a slip. You can call it also an emotional offset. You can call it a point of weakness or human nature. But the name is S-I-N. Tonight, where do we go from here? God will bless you. God will honor you. You may become greater than David. This is a difficult message for me. But God said, you've got to preach what I tell you. Because this church is moving to a higher direction. But I've got to clean some things up. Deuteronomy chapter 2 says, you've gone around this mountain for too long. Turn ye northward. Before God does any great thing, he wipes the slate clean. Tonight, the thing. We are in the public place. You can't miss a chance tonight. Bow your head. It's a very solemn night. It is good to go to church and get conviction that you are shaking in your boots. You may not have oil on your head, but you have conviction in your heart. That you go home and you are thinking, that what? So God has been seeing me. Oh, come on, I've got to stop this. Tonight, if you are here and you have anything in your life, my message is simple. That you think God is not pleased. Let's sort it out. That is homecoming all about. When you travel, you come back, your father asks you to say, then he advises you. We are not here to massage figures. I'm not here to preach and please you. No. God forbid. If you find out the truth, you blame us. So we ought to go to God to tell you as it is. Beyond money, beyond cars, if we don't make heaven, it's useless. It makes a mess of our work. If you are here tonight, it's between you and God. If there is anything in your life that displeases God, no matter how big, no matter how small, walk out here. Come and stand here before God. It's a very solemn atmosphere. Come. Come. I expect a full house. Come. Michel, come. Nobody saw what David did, but God saw it. Nobody saw it all. So the thing that David had done displeased the Lord. Maybe nobody will tell you what you have done is bad, but God has seen it. Keep coming forward. If you must cry, cry. If you must kneel down, kneel down. But sort it out tonight. It can block your promotion. And you may be betting me see we share coin. Man, that down. Sort it out. How can God bring you a word like this and I don't receive conviction? You know your problem. And you will sit down quiet. God forbid. You don't want to miss heaven. Keep coming. Keep coming. I expect a full house. Keep coming forward. Come forward. The thing that David had done. The thing. Everybody is between you and God. Your thing. Bring it here. Bring your thing to God. Keep coming forward. We have a whole crowd coming. Keep coming forward. They are coming. I expect a lot more. Keep coming. The thing. Holy Ghost is giving conviction right now. You are under torture. You are under torment. You are shaking. You are panting. Holy Ghost said, get up and go. I am sorting you out tonight. There are cobwebs. There are skeletons in the cupboard. Keep coming. Keep coming. You nearly died from the abortion. You are following somebody's husband. And the woman is praying against you. Come, let's sort it out. The thing that David had done displeased the Lord. Keep coming. This is coming. This is a church of righteousness. The first possession here is righteousness. Keep coming. No matter what blessing you receive, if you don't deal with God, you can lose it. Come, keep coming. There are about 20 more people seated. Keep coming. Keep coming. Number one, number two, number three, I'm going to draw a red line under. Keep coming. Can I get five more people? Number one, he's coming. Five. Keep coming. Keep coming. Sorina Bra. Keep coming. Number one, they are coming. They are coming. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Number two, keep coming. Number three, number four, number five, keep coming. It doesn't matter whether your friends come or not. Man of God, please come and stand with me here. Keep coming. Give me a worship song. This is a very strong atmosphere. Everybody, bow your head. Bow your head, everyone. Can you kneel down before God? This is a very serious thing. It's life and death. It's life and death. Life and death. Life and death. Kneel down before God. I'm going to kneel down myself. Pastor will kneel down. We'll stand in the gap and make the hedge. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God tonight. Confess it. Today there's no confession. Confess it before God. God, clean the record. Give me a new beginning. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. Sing it one more time. Everybody bow your head as we sing it. Sing it out loud.
I give you.
Pastor, can we pray for them? Pastor, please come and help. Pastor Steve, come. Just lay hands on them. God will forgive them, whatever it is. We cannot do it, but God will do it. You stand forgiven. 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 Whatever thing it is, God has forgiven
Lord,
you tonight. Makarataka satabaha.
Lord, I give you.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Son of God. There is forgiveness with God. Rakadabakataka shandabaha. Hey, Marakataka shaya. Holy Ghost.
Every breath.
Whatever thing it is tonight, God has forgiven you. God has forgiven you. God has forgiven you. My God.
Lord,
my God. My God. There's forgiveness with God. There's forgiveness. Any skeleton in the cupboard, let God wipe the slates. Let God give you a new beginning. Oh, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Spirit of God. Whatever thing it is, tonight, let the Spirit of God forgive you. Forgive you. You stand forgiven. Every guilt on your mind, you cannot pray, you cannot fast, you cannot come to communion. Tonight, you stand forgiven. Forgiven.
From thy presence, O Lord, and take not.
Pastor, who kneel down before God. My God. My God. Father, tonight is a solemn night. We are taking decisions about heaven and hell. It's only a thin line. Said you are just and faithful to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That if we confess our sins, you are just and you are faithful to forgive us and to cleanse us. Tonight, I join my faith to your servant and ask that whatever the nature of the sin, by the tokens of the blood of the everlasting covenant, we wipe out every handwriting of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, we declare it is nailed to the cross. And from tonight, may God give you a new beginning, that you will not go back to the place of offense. You will not go back like the pig to the place and the wallow of its sin. I declare that tonight the enemy has no charge against you. In your body, in your soul, in your will, in your mind, in your emotions. Whatever that thing is, we put it in the blood of Jesus. And Father, we thank you that tonight is a new page in the life of your people. In Jesus' name, amen.
So take my heart and more.
Bow your head, bow your heads. Sing me the song.
Take my mind.
Sing me the song.
Transform me.
Sing me the song, my friend.
Take my will. Conform me.
Kadabo Hoshata.
Do yours, oh Lord. Take my heart and more.
Tonight, my assignment is simple, day one. The tin. And God has taken care of it. Let's give God a big hand. And tonight, God has moved you from Bethel to El Bethel. You are not only in the house of God, you also know the God of the house of God. Now, your homecoming can begin. Tonight, day one, I don't want to push my luck. But we set a very solid platform upon which the superstructure will be built. And I want you to give an offering that befits the grace of God. Tonight, if not for anything at all, you are alive and well. And you want to say, God, I want to give you just 100 Ghana cedis. I want to give you just 500 Ghana cedis. Oh, sorry, 50 Ghana cedis. Whatever, 20 Ghana cedis. Let's come and lay it at the altar. Take it and bring it. That Lord, you kept me. This is a special offering of thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. That you kept me the whole of 2016. 2016, Bishop James, I never went to hospital. And if that is enough to give God thanks, why not? And I want somebody who said 2016, 2017, minkwa aspits. Minkwa aspits. My fancy people say aspits. Minkwa aspits. Come and make a covenant with God. That God, tonight, the money I will take to hospital, I'm putting at the altar. Minkwa aspits. Doctors will not be fighting for my survival. No, I'm going to give you that money. I want to make a covenant. Onyame, nimin diniye. Hundred Ghana cedis, what can he do? What can he do? Not much. Bring it to God. Bring it. I want to make a covenant with you. I want. Bring it. Lord, even as your servant has spoken, that 2016 he did not end up in hospital. Do the same for me. 2017. I will not be carried to hospital. I will not have a splitting headache. No. Lord, the money I will use for antibiotics, I want to give you. But now, shame so. To the Lord belongs escapes from death. His word is health to our body. That's what Proverbs says. The word of God is health. To all our body. Bra. 50 Ghana cedis, come and put it on. Make a covenant with God. Fabra. 50 Ghana cedis. Lord, I will not buy paracetamol. I buy the word of God. The word shall be life to my body. He sent his word and it healed them. The word. And delivered them from all their destruction. February, bring it. 50 Ghana cedis, bring it. Thank you, Grandpa. Bring it. 20. Bring it. I'm going to pray. Everybody, bring it. 20, 10. I won't assume everybody has come. 20s and 10s. Before I pray, run here. Run. Bring it. Bring it. 20s and 10s. Drop it there. Let's settle this matter. Thank you. Thank you. If you want to give more than I called, why not? 20s and 10s. And the choir. Singing is not an excuse for not giving. So you have hung a mic on your mouth by force. Macho life. I can come and wrestle the mic from your mouth. Bring it. So thou shalt sing and thou shalt give. 2 in 1. Thou shalt sing and thou shalt also give. For it pleaseth the Lord thy God. That's your scripture. Thou shalt sing and thou shalt give. For it pleaseth the Lord thy God that thou doest so. Good. Okay, finally. Anything you want to give, bring it before I close. Anything. All right. Bishop is going to pray. Thank you. Father in heaven, we thank you tonight. Your faithfulness can see to us through and through. Your word will not lie, that heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of the Lord will abide forever. Tonight is the beginning. Father, you have given us a sure foundation that in righteousness we shall be established. We shall not be established by sin and wickedness. Let righteousness be the pillars and the columns of our lives. I bless your people. And I declare that even as you showed me in Aburi, that this church is turning into a new direction. And that you are going to build great towers of grace. That people who are not here shall come in. That by virtue of the vision that lie ahead, you will raise great men, political figures, men of substance shall come in through the front door. They shall say, we have heard of your great works, and we have come with the wealth of the wicked to support you. Let it come to pass. For what my eyes have seen, my ears have heard, so shall it be. In Jesus' name, God bless you.
Omniscient, omnipotent, the one who does great things. Just can't hold back my praise. Yeah. The words you speak turn things around. Your outstretched arms have lifted me. For the Lord, what a word! What a word! What a powerful word! Say amen. This is the word that carries people to heaven. This is the word that cleanses a church. Bishop James, thank you very much. From hearing from God and coming to say exactly what the Lord wants you to say to us, and to open the conference with such a big, powerful
word.
Say amen. And because of technology, you can have the word on podcasts, on YouTube, on whatever, which means that you can hear it tomorrow morning again and hear the things you didn't hear tonight. You can send it to somebody. You can hear it for personal cleansing and development. And I think that Bishop James has started on a very good note. Because of us, we went on a waiting. And I like what he said, not for want of word, because Bishop James is a great teacher. He has taught. He can teach the whole year without repeating himself. He can teach every day for 365 days without repeating himself. God has blessed him. And so for him to go and wait upon the Lord for us means that he wants us to hear from God. We are very great. We thank you for accepting our invitation, and we thank you for praying for us and giving us the word that the Lord is going to shift this church on a new dimension. Wow. Thank you very much. Tomorrow we are going to have Dr. Abel Damina also coming from Nigeria. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. He has opened the way. Now a lot of things can flow. Blessings and breakthroughs. Bishop James has a lot of tapes. I read his tapes. I listen to his tapes. I read his books all the time. I have every message, because anytime he comes, anything he displays, I buy all of it. So I have his messages. And you would never get tired of listening to him. So where have all the leaders gone? I've never seen this one before, so it's like I have it now. Where have all the leaders gone? Wow. And then the miracle of sowing and reaping. Don't die. God is coming. I've never seen this one. Don't die. God is coming. And then give me back my baby. And then trials and temptation in the life of believers. The finger of God. All these books are on sale out there. They will be on sale throughout the convention. So get copies and be blessed. And then tonight's tape. Add tonight's CD to a collection of books. Go and withdraw some money and come and buy the whole set. Because he has brought it on a small discount here. Say amen. We have buses out there. Bus 1 is going to Atomic Junction, Zongo Junction, Adenta Housing Down, Ashadebo Trip. Bus 2 will go to Hacho, Atomic Down, St. John's, Tesano, Circle. Bus 3, Atomic Junction, Legon, Tetekwashi, 37. All these buses are going out. You can just join them. It's for free. You don't have to pay anything. We have paid them already. So it can be free for you. Hallelujah. See, here we are a lot of people. Tomorrow, invite friends and remind the others that the convention has started. We have a great visitor coming tomorrow. So let's be here and be blessed. When we close, pastors and elders, come to Bishop James. Hug him, love him, tell him that we love him and we cherish the word he has brought. He has brought the word with two-edged sword to cut all corners and everything. Shall we rise and close the service? Tomorrow, try and be here early. Because the man of God coming tomorrow, he needs a lot of time. So we want to put him on very early. Your hands start to lead.
From victory on to victory, his army shall he lead. Tell every foe is vanquished, and Christ is God in thee.
The Lord bless and keep you. May his face shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And above all, help all of us to deal with whatever thing is in your life, that this year it will be a sin-free, struggle-free life with the Lord. That anytime the Lord calls you, you are ready to go to paradise with him. Say amen. Shake three people and tell them the thing is dealt with. When you